We have a universe that is based on love. There is only love. There is only life. There is that power and that presence within each one of us that when we are ready will come up within us and burst forth into bloom and flower and harvest if we open up to it, such as the power of right thinking. It solves every problem. You got a problem? The mind of God within you knows the answer. I proved that by taking algebra in college. I was a straight A student. I don't know about trains and planes and automobiles. I don't know about X's and Y's and lines and all. I don't know about that, but I made A's because there is a mind within me that knows. And I would sit down in front of you people think I'm joking. I'm dead serious. I would sit down at the beginning of the test and I would go, I know that I'm one with all that there is and that the mind of God is my mind now. I know the mind of the person who created algebra is my mind now. I know the person that created this test is my mind now. I know that the person who grades the test is my mind now, and I know that those answers flow through me in the exact way they need to for this test. And then I would take the test. And in that moment, I would know exactly what I was doing, not 10 minutes later. But isn't it the moment that you need?
Right.
Right? And how many times do we have our intuition? You know there are more brain cells in your gut than in your head. How many times do we have that intuition, that connection with all that is, whisper, run, run. Don't marry that person. Don't invest in that business. Don't buy that car. Don't walk down that street. Run. And if we listen to it, things work out. And if we don't, then we get to experience the effect of our causes. I know this teaching works. I found this teaching when I had a three-year-old child. I had no money, and I was sleeping on someone's floor. I had no prospects. I had no sense that I was anybody. I dropped out of high school at 15. I was an alcoholic. I was a drug addict. I was nobody. And somebody said, that's a lie. You're somebody. Not only are you somebody, but you are all that there is. And I went, oh no, my God doesn't like me. My God goes out of its way to hurt me, to set me up, to cause me to fail. And they said that God is a lie. That there's only a power and a presence of love and light. That that is all that there could be, and it is manifest at the point of view now. They told me I was loved beyond my wildest dreams, and that I deserved to be wealthy, to be healthy, to be happy, and to feel whole. And I was foolish enough to grab on it because I had nothing to lose but the life I was living. I'll always tell you, I guarantee my teachings. If you don't like it, you can have your old life back. Very rarely does anyone take me up on that. We are spiritual beings, and spirit is alive and well at the point of us. We can use that through the power of right thinking, which means we see that. We look in the mirror and we see this being of light and love and power and glory. We look in the mirror and we know that within us is everything that we need to have whatever it is we choose to have in life. That we are loved and supported by life, and so is everyone else. There is only one. There is only one God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord thy God is one. There's only one. There's not pieces of God and religion and humanity pitted against each other. Could you imagine if you had two infinite powers? They would collide. There wouldn't even be time and space for us to hang out and discuss the subtleties of it all. It cannot be. There must be one. There is a power and a presence of love and light and life. It is eternal and absolute, and it is there for us. We don't have to earn it. We don't have to go out and buy it. We don't have to find it. It's not hidden. It's right here in us. And if we open up and allow that presence of the divine that we are to rise up within us, we will find an us that we never knew existed. We will find a clarity, a self-assurance. We will find the answers and the courage to step forward and to take the life that is ours to live. That's already in us. It's already in us. These are the ideas of Science of Mind, based on the idea of oneness, that in order for spirit to be, it must be in all of its glory and magnificence in you today. And as we open up to that, then the impossible becomes possible and miracles become everyday occurrences. As we open up to the spiritual being that we are, then the God that we have, for me, is more real than anything I ever heard about in my childhood or read about in a book. That presence of spirit that lives and moves and has its being as us lifts us. When we learn how to think, when we learn how to speak, and when we learn how to live. And so it is.